Hi, this is Sujay Devi from Royal Cyber. In this video, we are going to see what is RDQM and how to implement high availability of MQ using this technique. So, what is RDQM? RDQM stands for Replicated Data Queue Manager. This concept is used to implement a high available solution. So, let's see where RDQM can be installed. RDQM is available from MQ version 9.1.0.2 onwards. Currently, this is supported only on RHEL 7.1 onwards. Lower versions of RHEL are not supported. It is not available on other platforms too. You can use RDQM for your DR strategy as well, but this video will specifically focus on how to achieve high availability using RDQM. Let's see the concept of RDQM high availability. A typical RDQM HA setup requires at least 3 nodes as shown here. And this architecture will be used in this video to demonstrate how to achieve HA using this technique. Each node will have an instance of queue manager. One node will act as primary node and other 2 nodes act as secondary node. So the primary node has the running instance of queue manager, which synchronously replicates its data to the other 2 queue managers on the remaining 2 nodes. So when the primary node goes down or if some failure activity occurs in node 1, either node 2 or node 3 will become the primary node and will have the running instance of queue manager. Before we dive further, let's look at some of the prerequisites for setting up RDQM installation. Install these packages on your nodes. Install MQ version 9.1.0.2 on all 3 nodes. Create a volume group called DRDB pool on each node and add a physical interface to add floating IP address. Now let's see how to achieve HA using RDQM and the steps to implement it. As said, RDQM HA feature has 3 nodes. Here we have 3 nodes as RDQM node 1, RDQM node 2 and RDQM node 3. On each node, register and subscribe to Red Hat repository. If it is registered, the status will be current. On each node, install these prerequisite packages. After installing prerequisite packages on each node, install MQ version 9.1. Run this command to import public linbit gpg key. Move to RDQM directory. List the files inside that directory. Run install RDQM support package on each node to install RDQM and dependent packages. After running install RDQM support package, move to opt mqm samp RDQM firewall d directory and list the files. Run this configure.sh script to allow traffic between the nodes. Run the script on each node. Create a volume group called DRBD pool on each node. Move to var mqm directory and edit rdqm.ini file with IP addresses of all the nodes. Edit this file on each node. move to opt-mqm bin directory. And run rdqmadm-c to configure replicated data subsystem. Run the same command on other two nodes. Now our replicated data subsystem is ready. We'll check the status of the subsystem. Use rdqm status-n command to check the status of the nodes. Are all the three nodes are online now? Now our system is ready to create QManager. First, we need to create secondary QManagers and then we have to create primary QManager. In rdqm node 1, we'll create primary QManager and we'll create secondary QManagers on rdqm node 2 and rdqm node 3. First, I'll create secondary QManager on rdqm node 2. The command to create secondary QManager is crtmqm-sxs and the QManager name. I'm naming my QManager as rdqm-ha1. Secondary QManager is created on node 2. Now I'll run the same command to create secondary QManager on node 3. Secondary QManagers are created. Now I'll create primary QManager on rdqm node 1. Run the same command without this S so that it will create primary QManager. Primary QManager is also got created. Now we'll check the status of QManager. Command to check status of QManager is rdqm status-m and the QManager name. rdqm node 1 is the primary node and QManager is running here. QManager is running on rdqm node 1, which is the primary node. We'll run the same command on other two nodes as well. So other two nodes are secondary nodes. Here floating IP address is none. We'll add floating IP address to this QManager. And the floating IP address should be added to the primary node. The command to add floating IP address is rdqm-int-m QManager name -a to add -f floating IP address -l the device name. Floating IP address has been added to the QManager. This floating IP address should be in the same subnet of the three nodes. Now we'll check the status of the QManager. Now floating IP address is reflected in the status command. Now to check the failure condition, we'll bring down this primary node and check the status of the QManager. Now I'm shutting down this primary node. Shutting down rdqm node 1. Now rdqm node 1 is down now. We'll check the status of QManager. Run the status command on both the nodes, rdqm node 2 and rdqm node 3. QManager is now running on rdqm node 2 and rdqm node 3 is still secondary. This shows the high availability of rdqm nodes if a node goes down. We have come to the end of this video. If you need help in setting up rdqm on your environment, Royal Cyber will be happy to help. You can drop us a note at info@royalcyber.com. Thank you for watching.